Hey, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover how to use the allowance method. Now, it's common in business to allow customers to pay for products or services at a later date, called selling on credit. Unfortunately, some of those customers won't pay us back. Using the allowance method, we estimate these losses from uncollectible accounts and record bad debts expense at the end of the accounting period. So let's do an example. Assume we had credit sales of $900,000 in our first year of business. And at the end of the first year, $80,000 of those credit sales have not yet been collected. We expect most of these accounts receivable to be collected. But unfortunately, we estimate that $6,000 will be uncollectible. We cover how to estimate this in other videos. But for now, let's record this estimate by debiting bad debts expense for $6,000 and crediting allowance for doubtful accounts for $6,000. So we know that bad debts expense is reported on the income statement. But what is allowance for doubtful accounts? The allowance for doubtful accounts is a contra asset account, meaning it has a normal credit balance and reduces the accounts receivable account. Let me show you how this is reported on the balance sheet. We show $80,000 in accounts receivable because this is the amount of sales not yet collected. Next, we report allowance for doubtful accounts as a $6,000 subtraction from accounts receivable. The $6,000 is the amount we estimated as uncollectible. Therefore, the realizable value, or the amount we actually expect to receive, is $74,000. Again, the $74,000 is the $80,000 owed to us minus the $6,000 that we estimate will be bad debts. We can also report this on the balance sheet as accounts receivable net of doubtful accounts as $74,000. So that's how we record our estimate of uncollectibles. Now, what happens when we actually determine an account is uncollectible? Using the allowance method, we reduce the allowance for doubtful accounts and accounts receivable. For example, let's say that after estimating our bad debts expense at year end, we determine that our customer Weber's 800 account is uncollectible. To record this, we debit allowance for doubtful accounts for 800 and credit accounts receivable for 800. The debit to allowance for doubtful accounts reduces that account, and the credit to accounts receivable removes 800 from that account. You'll notice we don't record any expense when we determine the account is uncollectible. This is because under the allowance method, we already recorded that expense when we estimated it at year end. This entry also does not affect the realizable value of accounts receivable. Now assume a couple months later, the customer all of a sudden pays us the $800 that was due. To account for this, we need to record two entries. One, to reverse the entry we just made and reinstate that customer's account. And a second, to record cash received. So first, to reverse the effects of the entry we just made, we debit accounts receivable for 800 to reinstate and increase accounts receivable, and we credit allowance for doubtful accounts for 800. Now for the second entry, to record cash received, we debit cash for 800 and credit accounts receivable for 800. The debit to cash increases it for the payment received from the customer. And we credit accounts receivable because the customer paid off the account.